Good morning, students. Now, in number system, the next topic we are going to see is laws of exponents. In earlier classes in 7th standard and also in 8th standard, you have read these laws. For example, what is exponent? A to the power m. If you write like this, A is called base, m is called exponent, that you know already. So using this, laws are there. So laws of exponents, the few laws you already know very well. So a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. The bases are same, powers are different, and if you multiply same base, you have to add the power. And the second one, same base with different power is divided, a power n by a power n. What happens? The power subtracted, a power n minus n. And now a power n whole power n, power to power, base is a, where two powers are there. For m, again a power n. So you have to just multiply both powers, that is a power m into n, that is a power mn. And the next law, a to the power minus m, negative power. So to make it positive exponent, we have to take reciprocal, 1 by a power m. A power minus m is equal to 1 by a power m. And coming to next, a power m into b power m. Here you notice that both a and b different base, m same power. So different base with same power, when you multiply, what happens? Just you multiply the bases and put the same power. So a power m into b power m is equal to ab whole power m. The next one, the same like fifth one, different base, same power, the bases are dividing here. A power m by b power m is equal to a by b whole power m. And now coming to seventh one, a by b whole power minus m. We get also negative exponent. So just we interchange the numerator and denominator to get positive exponent. So a by b becomes b by a, and the power, that is the exponent, becomes positive, minus m becomes m. And now coming to 8th one, a power m whole power 1 by n. So power to power, so like this, a power m to the power n. What happens? Just we multiply the powers like that. Here also, if you multiply m and 1 by n, what happens? M into 1 by n, that is equal to m by n. So that is the result, a power m by n. And this you can interchange the power, 1 by n you can put inside, and m raising power a power 1 by n to whole power m. So like that we can do this and get the result a power m by n. And you know that any base with the exponent 0, a power 0, what answer? 1. What answer you will get? 1. So any base with exponent 0, you get 1. And the next definition is there about the square root of a number. You know, square root means just we put the root symbol. The root symbol is called radical sign. The symbol, the root symbol is called radical sign. That symbol is not only for square root, any root you can put, but that symbol is called radical sign. And nth root of a greater than 0, n a positive integer, a any real number, and nth root of a, how to read this? Nth root of a equal to b. if b power n equal to a. Suppose b power n equal to a is an equation, and if you want b, then you have to raise power to 1 by n. So b power n equal to a, then if you raise to the power 1 by n, what happens? B power n whole power 1 by n, and here a power 1 by n, and then here if you multiply power to power, then n gets cancelled, you get b power 1, which is nothing but b, that is equal to a power 1 by n. We can write as nth root of a, nth root of a. So for example, you write cube root of 8, you can write this as a power 1 by 3, yes sir, and this 8 is nothing but 2 cube, and again to the power 1 by 3. Now the power you have to multiply, 3 and 1 by 3, if we multiply, what happens? 3 gets cancelled, and it comes as 2 power 1, which is nothing but 2. So like that, here we say cube root of 8, and simply if you put root 5, so root 5, and there is no nth root, means it means root square root of 5, this square root of 5. If you put 3, that is cube root of 8. So like that, nth root of a equal to b. Like that, the definition is there. We define nth root of a equal to a power 1 by n. If you put 3, then here we get 1 by 3. If it is 5, you get 1 by 5. And if it is any number, that is generally n, nth root of a is equal to a power 1 by n. Now it clear? Okay. Now I already given some example. So like that, cube root of 2, you can write as 2 power 1 by 3, 4 power 3 by 2. So here I wrote clearly, but it's not visible. So you see here, 4 power 3 by 2. 4 power 3 by 2. This you can write as 4 power 1 by 2 into 3. So 3 by 2 you can write as 1 by 2 into 3. 1 by 2 into 3. And this 4 power 1 by 2, that is nothing but square root of 4 and whole cube. What is square root of 4? That you know well. That is 2, and then the power is 3. And 2 cube is what? 8. So here also I wrote the same. 4 power 3 by 2, you can write like this, and you get 8. And another way, 4 power 3 by 2, if you write like this, 4 cube into 1 by 2, you can write like this also. 4 power 3 by 2, you can write in another way, 4 cube into the whole to the power 1 by 2, that means 3 into 1 by 2, and 4 cube becomes 16, 4. 4 to the power 1 by 2, that is nothing but square root of 64, which is 8. Is it clear? Okay. So like that, in general, we can write a power m by n as nth root of a whole power m, or nth root of a power m. So like that, in any way you can write a power m by n. Clear, children? Now coming to the exercise 1.6, by using all these laws of exponents, we can find the value of the given sum. The first question, option 1, they are asking to find the value of 64 power 1 by 2. So how to do? 64 is the base and the exponent is 1 by 2. So the denominator of the exponent is 2. Therefore, we try to convert 64 as number with power 2. Then you can easily cancel 2, 2. If you make 64 as a number with power 2, then it is easy to cancel. Okay, children, do you understand? So how we can make 64 as a number with power 2? 64 is nothing but 8 square. You know, 64 is 8 square. 8 into 8, that is 64. So 8 square and whole to the power 1 by 2. So now the power 2, 2, because 2 into 1 by 2, if we cancel, we get 1. So we can cancel this and then it becomes 8 power 1, which is nothing but 8. Is it clear? By applying this law, a power m to the whole power n is a power mn. So applying this, we can make it 64 as 8 square, and then the power 1 by 2 already is there, so you write that as it is, and then power to power, so you have to multiply like this, you get 1, so 8 power 1 is nothing but 8. And now we move to the next question. 32 whole power 1 by 1. So here the question is 32 to the power 1 by 5. The exponent is 1 by 5. So what is the fraction exponent is given here? So what is the denominator of the exponent 5? So we try to make the base 32 as a number with power 5. As I told you earlier, 32 is nothing but 2 power 5 and then 1 power 1 by 5. So by observing the base of the exponent, you have to change the base as exponent form. 32 we can write in exponent form as 2 power 5. Then you know how to find that. 32 means 2 16s are 32, again 2 8s are 16, and then again 2 4s are 8, and then 2 2s are 4, 2 1 is 2. So how many 2? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 2 power 5 is nothing but 32. This is 32, a number, but in exponent form we can write 32 as 2 power 5. So now we can cancel 5 and 5, because 5 into 1 by 5, power into power, we get only 2 power 1, which is nothing but 2. So the answer of 32 power 1 by 5 is nothing but 2. Okay, and the next option is there, 125 whole power 1 by 3, and you do a square mark. Okay, and now coming to question number 2 of the same exercise. Option 1. Here also we have to find the value. It is given 9 power 3 by 2. 9 power 3 by 2. So this is what given, 9 power 3 by 2. So here we have to observe that exponent 3 by 2 and the denominator of the exponent is 2. So what to do here? So we have to try to make the base with a number of exponent 2. So 9 we can write as 3 square. 3 into 3, 9. And then the exponent is 3 by 2. So now just you multiply power into power. What do you get? 2, 2 cancel. You get 3 alone. Am I right? And now we can write after cancelling this only 3 cube. So what is this? 3 into 3, again into 3, you get 27. So 27 is the answer for 9 power 3 by 2. The next question, 32 power 2 by 5. So here the base is 32 and the exponent is 2/5. So we can observe the denominator of the exponent is 5, and now we have to make 32 as a number with power 5. Then only it is very easy to cancel the denominator. So already we have written that 32 as 2/5, and then 4^2/5. So now 5 × 2/5. What happens? 5 cancel, and you get only 2. Am I right, children? So 32 becomes 2/5, and again power with power, if you multiply, you get 2 after cancelling this 5 and 5. So what happens? You get only 2 power. That means 2 square. What is the answer? 4. So it's simple. So like that, any sum we can follow the exponent law, and you can easily find the answer. And now the next question. So the base is 16. What is the exponent? 3/4. So in you observe the denominator of the exponent. What is that? 4. So you try to make 16 as a number with power 4. So 16, just you put like this, then type division and find the prime factors. 2 8s are 16, 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4, 2 1 is 2. So we can write 16 as 2 × 2 × 2 × 2. So that means what? 2/4. 2/4. 16 is nothing but 2/4. So 16 we have written in exponent form as 2/4. And again the power is given with 3/4. So now 4 × 3/4. 2/4, 4^3/4. So like this. Or like this, a^m × 1/n. So here we are making the power multiply. What you get? 4 × 3/4. You get only 3 after cancelling this. When you multiply power with another power, 4 × 3/4, you get only 3. So this is nothing but 2 cube, which is nothing but 8. 2 cube is 8. So very easy to get the answer. The next one, 125 / -1/3. And now you listen here. Here the base is 125, and the exponent is -1/3. So negative exponent. So here, you are able to see a^-m, the fourth one, a^-m, which is nothing but 1/a^m. So we are trying to make the exponent as positive power. So for that you have to take the reciprocal, then you get positive exponent. So by applying the same here, the base is 125. So you can write this as 125 into 10 whole power minus 1 by 3 as 5 cube. You apply the negative exponent. Here you do the same power. So after simplifying the power, we just change the negative exponent to positive by applying that law. So 125 is nothing but 5 cube. 125 and again 5 are 25 and again 5 1 is 5. So how many 5? 3. 5 into 5 into 5, you get 5 cube, which is the exponent form of 125. And in the power it is minus 1 by 3. So now what happens? 3 into minus 1 by 3. We cancel 3, you get minus 1. Minus 1. So you can write this as 5 power minus 1. And now it is very easy to apply the fourth law. A power minus m is equal to 1 by a power m. You can write this as 1 by 5 power 1. So here the exponent is minus 1. By writing in reciprocal, the negative exponent minus 1 becomes plus 1. That is 5 power 1. 1 by 5 power 1. And this you can write as 1 by 5 power 1 is 5. 1 by 5. So 125 whole power minus 1 by 3 becomes 1 by 5. So first of all we have to change this 125 as 5 cube, and after cancelling the power into power you get 5 power minus 1. Here you apply that law, a power minus m is equal to a power minus m is equal to 1 by a power m. So this is the law we have applied. Okay, so 5 power minus 1 is equal to 1 by 5 power 1, and again you get 1 by 5. And now coming to the question number 3, the first option, simplify 2 power 2 by 3 into 2 power 1 by 5. Here the into symbol they given as dot, dot means multiply. So the bases are two, same base, the powers are different, same base different power. So what is the power here? 2 by 3, and what is the power here? 1 by 5. So same base different exponent. So we have to apply this law, a power m into a power n. You see here, I wrote here, a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. So same base is multiplying, so for that we have to add the power. So here what to do? 2 power 2 by 3 plus 1 by 5. So you have to add the exponent for the same base when you multiply. So now you see in this exponent 2 by 3 plus 1 by 5 is nothing but addition of two fractions. So simply you can do here 2 by 3 plus 1 by 5. So how will you do? By taking LCM. So this is what you read in the previous classes 5, 6 and all. So addition of fractions. So we have to take LCM for 3 and 5. What is that? 15. And what will come in the numerator? So this here 3 into 5 only you get 15. So in the denominator also if you multiply by 5 you get 10. And here 5 into 3 it becomes 15. So you have to multiply the same 3 in the numerator also. So 1 into 3 you get 3. So 10 plus 3, what is that? 13. 10 plus 3, 13. You get 30 by 15. So here The same process he can apply here. By doing like this in the left column, we can directly put this, or you just do the same thing like this only, 15 and here 10 plus 3. So this is nothing but 2 power 13 by 15. So 2 power 2 by 3 into 2 power 1 by 5 is simplified as 2 to the power 13 by 15. So by applying that law, a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. And now come to the next question. By 3 cube 1 by 3 cube 4th power 7 so it is given that 1 by 3 cube whole to the power 7 so how to do this so the numerator here 1 and the denominator here 3 cube. So you have to apply the exponent 7 for both numerator and denominator. So here if you apply 1 power 7 and here 3 cube whole power 7. We have to apply the exponent for both numerator and denominator. So like this, a by b whole power m, you can take as a power m by b power m. Separately, we can apply the power to the numerator and denominator. And here, 1 power 7, you get 1 only. If you apply any power to 1, you get only 1. And here in the denominator, it is 3 power 3 into 7. So it is nothing but a power m whole power n is nothing but a power m n. That law you have to apply here. So 3 cube whole to the power 7. So what will come? 3 into 7. You can write this. And here we get 1 by 3 power 20. 1 by 3 power 21. So that is the answer. And now 1 by 3 power 21, if you want, you can write as 3 to the power minus 21. Because in the denominator, 3 power 21 is there. So write like this. The exponent sign will change. So here 3 power 21. If you write like this, we get 3 to the power minus 21. So like that, a power m, that is 1 by a power m, you can write as a power minus m. By applying this law, 1 by a power m is equal to a power minus m. So there you can see in the chart also. So 1 by a power m, if you want to write like this, you can change here a power minus m, the power of the exponent you can change, the exponent sign is m, when you write like this it becomes minus m, so a power minus m. So here also 1 by 3 power 21 becomes 3 power minus 21. And now next question. Option 3, it is given that 11 power 1 by 2 divided by 11 power 1 by 4 11 power 1 by 2 divided by 11 power 1 by 4 so this is like a power m divided by a power n which is a power m minus n by applying this law this is called quotient law so you can apply this law and you can write like this the base is 11 in both numerator and denominator the base is 11 so by applying this law you can write this as 11 to the power 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4 11 to the power 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4 so the half minus quarter do you know what is the answer directly half minus quarter when we subtract quarter from half what do you get yes 1 by 4 but how to do in algebraic way so by taking LCM this is nothing but 4 LCM of 2 and 4 is 4 only and in the numerator 1 is there so here we have to multiply by 2 to get 4 so 1 into 2 2 minus here 4 into 1 4 so into 1 means what do you get 1 and this is nothing but 11 to the power 2 minus 1 is 1 by 4 so this is what I told you half minus quarter is nothing but again 1 by 4 the part will come right so the answer of 11 power 1 by 2 by 11 power 1 by 4 is 11 to the power 1 by 4 now we will move to the next question of the same third question the last one of this last sum of this chapter seven power one by two into eight power one by two seven power one by two into eight power one by two so here this dot represents multiplication so here you notice please notice that the bases are different the exponent are same you see here the base is seven the exponent is one by two here the base is 8 the exponent is 1 by 2 so it is like that a power m into b power m so this law a power m into b power m is nothing but ab whole power m so you can write ab just multiply the base and put the common power m by applying this exponent law here we will get the answer so this is nothing but 7 into 8 whole to the power 1 by 2 because for both base 1 by 2 is the common power so what is 7 by 8 56 there is so this is nothing but 56 power 1 by 2 so this is the answer okay and now that we finish now we finish the chapter but we have to recap the topics all the topics what we have seen in this chapter and worksheet also we are sending and for this exercise also we will provide a worksheet and you finish it and come and just I will recap what are the key points we have discussed so far. So first of all, rational number, you know, rational number is nothing but a number which can be written in the form p by q, where p and q are integers, q not equal to 0. And what is irrational? A number which cannot be written in the form p by q, but are irrational numbers. So rational and irrational together form real numbers. And then number line, how to locate a number, given number on number line, and a number may be of square root of 2, square root of 3, how to locate it on number line, we have discussed it. And also spiral also we have discussed. And the operation on real numbers, the previous class we have discussed the operations and its properties, everything. And the rationalizing, that is very important one. You can expect the questions in 3 mark 4 mark, rationalizing the denominator, and extra sums also we have discussed. So these are the topics in the previous classes we have discussed. And now exercise 1.6, laws of exponents. So you have to thorough all from the beginning. So the chapter, first chapter, number system, it's over.